In today's video, I'm going to teach you how to bid on Google Ads. So by default, when you set up a Google Ads campaign, it's probably going to be on the automatic bidding method. This is great for most people, but in some cases that you might want to put your bidding onto manual bidding, and you might want to set this up yourself. So what I'm going to do today is I'm going to teach you how to do it. I'm going to teach you strategies, and I'm going to teach you reasons why you might want to do this. So before we get started, I want to say please make sure you watch the whole video the whole way through to ensure that you get every step correct and you don't miss anything out. Because if you do, then you might mess something up and you might end up spending loads of money or something like that. So just watch the whole video to be sure you get it correct. With that being said, let's get straight into this. So the first thing we want to do is we want to go onto our browser like Google or whatever, and we want to sign in. So you can see right now I'm signed into Google, and then we want to go to the Google Ads website. So it's ads.google.com. Now from here it's going to look like this, and I'm going to create a new campaign to show you. So new campaign. So obviously here we would select the objective we want, so we can select sales if we'd like to. Nice. And then we can go select the campaign type, so search, performance max, display, video discovery. There's tons of different ones we can do here. So I'm going to click search for now, and you know it's going to ask you what goal you want. Let's say website visits. Or let's just ignore that for now. We can also create our tracking action, all that stuff. If you need to know about this, then let me know and I'll make a video on it. So I'm going to just continue, and it's going to ask if I want to continue with this one. I'm going to start new to create a new campaign. So what do we want to focus on? Conversions, clicks, impressions. So to do conversions, we have to set up our conversion tracking, which I haven't done, but you can click on those. So I'm going to do clicks for now, and we can click set a maximum cost per click bid limit. So what this means is the maximum cost per click bid limit is an advanced option for people who want more control over their maximized clicks bid strategy. A bid limit lets you control the maximum amount you'll pay for each click. To let Google automatically set your bids, leave this field blank. So this is one way of manually bidding. So let's say we have a pharmacy and we want to get clicks for a pound. If we don't want anything more than a pound, we'll put it at the pound and it won't go above that. Now what this will mean is that you will get clicks for a pound, but if you're getting outbidded, then you won't get any clicks and you'll get no traffic whatsoever. So you have to set this reasonably. This isn't some like magic strategy just to get cheap clicks. You have to set this reasonably to be competitive in your bids. So the way you can do this is you can, you know, set a few campaigns up, have a £1 bid, £2, £3, £4, £5, and see, you know, which one's getting the actual bids. You know, if like the £1 one doesn't, but the £2 one does, then you might know, okay, between £1 and £2, I could probably get a bid. So you can fiddle around with that until you get something good. One thing I'd recommend is doing like 33s or 77s, so £1.33 or £1.77. This always seems to work better than just whole numbers. With that being said, we can go on to some more settings. So what we can actually do as well is we can go on impression share. So where do you want your ads to appear? Anywhere on the page, top of page, let's say that. Percent of impressions you want to get, so is how often you want your ads to appear in the search area, so like we can say like 10-20%, and we can also set the maximum CPC here again. Now we can apply here to, go back to that. It says we can bid more effectively with clicks, so that's what they recommend. So you can click apply here, and that's going to put us back to the clicks option there. Now down here we can go to this section that says only bid for new customers. So this option limits your ads to only new customers regardless of your bid strategy. So basically what this means is it will only try and get new customers for you. Now this campaign won't run because I don't have a existing customer list defined. So I have to export all of my customers from my store or whatever it is, put it into here, and then it will be able to avoid those people. Obviously it won't be perfect because it will only have some data points, but it will be pretty good. So I can click next on here, and these are general settings. We all know what these are. We don't need to fiddle with as much. Now we can fiddle with more bidding settings. We can go down here and we can change the rotation of them. So you can do that. You can change the scheduling. So a good thing you could do is like if you have like if your thing's really popular in the morning, like people are checking your website out at like 9 till 10, you could put this on 9 till 10 and have like accelerate the bidding Have a higher cost per click so that it would accelerate your bidding and you would get a lot of customers in that time frame. For example, if it was like a high converting time period and you knew that you could spend more on ads, that's something that you could do. From here, we can change the dynamic targeting and we can change the restrictions, all of that good stuff. This is the keywords, we all know about this. Scrolling down. Is our daily budget, so we can just put $10 or whatever we want. Okay, it says. There we go. And it's just checking for errors, which there will be some errors. So back into here, back into the bidding, like there are more options. So if we go into conversions, you'll be able to bid in more settings. But generally, what I would recommend is, try out some different bid amounts on like conversions or whatever you want, and set a few campaigns up and see which ones spend, which ones don't, which ones are profitable. Because you might find that some are really profitable, and some aren't. So the main thing is just that you want to do a lot of testing with it, really. That's one of the big things. Now you can do this for other things as well. So if I created a new campaign here. I could do this for leads, for example. I can say display, or I could say performance max actually. Continue. I have to set up some tracking here. Continue. So now I can focus on the conversions or the conversion value. So what I can do here is I can set a target cost. So this is, so if I do target cost, that's going to be. It says it basically it's a bid, so it sets a bid to help get as many customers as possible at or below the target cost per action you set. Some conversions may cost more or less than your target. Basically, this means that it's going to be a bit more conservative your bidding, or maybe not conservative your bidding, depending on how you depending on how much you put in there. So if you if like £1 per lead is generally pretty easy to get for you. If you put a £5 CPA in here, then you're going to be able to get loads and loads and loads of leads. So it's good for outbidding people, but it's not good for low pricing in that way. Again, we can do this with the conversion value section. We can set a target return on ad spend. So your target ROAS is the average conversion value you'd like to get for each dollar you spend on ads. Enter a value as percentage in the formula. Conversion value divided by ad spend. So let's say conversion value is £10 divided by ad spend, let's say £1. So 10 divided by 1 is, well, let's say 2, so it's 5 times 100%. So 500% would be our target percentage. So whatever percent increase. So if you want to double, if you want to get what £2 back for every £1, you'd put 200%. That's how you would do it. This is here. For example, if your goal is to get an average of £5 in sales for each £1 you spend, your target ROAS would be 500%. So basically, you can set that here, and yeah, that is basically how you do it. Now, these are all, of course, just things you need to test, and they're not necessarily going to work for everybody, but in some cases, they will be really effective and they're worth giving a shot. Now, if you enjoyed this video and found it useful, be sure to like, subscribe, and comment down below that it helped. Thank you for watching.